Cyberspace has become part and parcel of our daily lives. But with the benefits of connectivity also come the drawbacks. We carry out our lives increasingly in the online world. Many of us have smartphones, smart cars, and smart houses. We may shop online, bank online, and socialize online. Cyberspace affects all of our lives, but it also leaves us vulnerable to attacks. Our militaries and armed forces are no different, and so we need to take steps to defend ourselves in cyberspace. NATO's approach to cyber defense has been driven by geopolitical events, such as the cyber attacks in Estonia in 2007, the use of cyber tools as a potential component of military operations, such as in Georgia in 2008, and the events in Ukraine in 2014. NATO and its allies need to be prepared to deal with these challenges because it is hard to imagine a conflict or crisis that would not include a cyber dimension. So what are we doing? Both NATO as an organization and its allies are taking measures to build defenses and enhance resilience by developing capabilities, building partnerships with other countries, international organizations, industry, and academia. Progress has been made, but the challenges are constant and demand continuous effort. We recognize that we all stand to benefit from a norms-based, predictable, and secure cyberspace. The impact of a cyber attack on one ally could be as harmful as a conventional attack. NATO is committed to defend all allies in cyberspace, as well as on land, in the air, or at sea.